morning, this is Shom Shikha presenting before you today's bulletin. First, the COVID-19 update. In India, the total tally of confirmed corona cases rises to 1,38,845, out of which 57,720 people recovered and 4,021 people lost their lives. With that, 77,103 active cases in India till now. In Assam, the confirmed corona case rises to 427, out of which 57 people recovered and 4 persons lost their lives. With that, 363 active cases in Assam till now. Now the national news. As the country's COVID-19 count continued to surge, India overtook Iran on Sunday in total recorded cases of the coronavirus to take the 10th spot among nations worst hit by the pandemic. New cases reported in the past 24 hours spiraled to 6,566, the highest single-day rise so far. Eid ul-Fitr is being celebrated across the country today. For the first time, when there will be no mass namaz at mosques and idgahs across the country. Sahih Imam of Delhi Jamaa Masjid, Shahid Ahmad Bukhari, has appealed to people not to come to mosques to offer prayers and offer namaz at home in view of the pandemic. The festival heralding the end of the fasting month of Ramzan was celebrated in Jammu and Kashmir and Kerala yesterday. Center has once again clarified that only passenger without COVID-19 symptom will be allowed to fly. Domestic flights in the country will resume operations today, except in Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal. Civil Aviation Minister Hardeep Singh Puri said that the flight operation from Vijayawada and Visakhapatnam airports in Andhra Pradesh will begin tomorrow, while those in West Bengal will recommence from Thursday on a limited scale. In Chennai, there will be a maximum of 25 arrivals, but there is no limit on number of departures. Now the sports news. On Tuesday, the ICC board will meet to lay down the procedure for the election. 2 days later, on 28th May, the board will meet again and is likely to announce the timeline for filling nominations. The BCCI will try to build consensus for the next ICC chair as the incumbent Shashank Manohar vacates the post in July. In Bundesliga, the Timo Werner opened the scoring for the RB Leipzig in the 11th minute and became the club's all-time top scorer with his third in the 75th minute, his 24th goal of the season. Now the news from Northeast. 3 more corona positive cases reported in Tripura. Tripura Chief Minister Biplab Kumar Deb informed that the samples of 991 people who returned from Delhi by Rajdhani Express were taken, out of which 3 were detected as positive. The total tally of Tripura rises to 192. 35 new cases of COVID-19 positive cases in Assam. 18 from Golaghat, 6 from Kokrajhar Quarantine Center, 5 from Karimganj, 2 from Tinsukia, 2 from Shivsagar, 1 from Jorhat and 1 from Dhemaji. With that, the total corona cases in Assam rises to 427. Gyan Riksha, new TV channel started by Assam government for the student of class 1 to class 12. This audio-visual TV channel classes will be taken by an experienced teacher. On Sunday, Himanta Biswa Sharma inaugurated Gyan Riksha in Sarvashiksha Avigyan office and said, in this lockdown period, when all the schools and colleges are closed, that channel will be beneficial for the students. Students of class 11 and 12 can collect their books from Wednesday onwards. Now the regional news. 5% from the age group of 22 to 27 are found corona positive from Karimganj. MP of Silchar Rajdeep Rai said they have a definite travel history. They are in ISBT Ramnagar and one in Karimganj, with that 47 corona cases in Barak Valley. Finally, flights from Kumbhigram Airport will land on Monday. Deputy Commissioner Kiti Jhali took a round of airport and look after the initiatives. All are requested to follow the guidelines given by airport. In a day, 380 passengers can only travel by air. After 65 years, Archana Nandi's positive case, Kiti Jhali said, community transmission started in Silchar, so people with no reason should not get out of their house and should take all the precautionary measures. Hostel of Assam University was requisitioned as quarantine center. Students are said to collect their stuff from hostel within 4 p.m. on 26th of May. Their parents or guardian may also take the things. Student ID are needed. But if they can't, then district administrative officer will open the door and collect the things and separately pack and mark their belongings for collection at a later date to be notified later. But this declaration made the student panic, because many of the students are outside the Assam. It is practically impossible for them to collect the things within 2 days. Many claims their certificates and important stuffs are there in the room. University should take the responsibility of all the belongings, said by one student of Tripura in a Facebook post. With that, I came to the today's bulletin. Have a nice day. Thank you.